That's a very undulating green. It's interesting to suddenly see it in the slightly golden light. It's coming up to 4 o'clock. This is my 9th hole, but it's hole number 10 because we started on the 2nd. And I've basically disliked virtually every moment of this so far because it's been far too busy. It's the first time I've been on my own. I've been playing with two other members and it's been fine, but just irritating, all the carts and the sense of newness and how unpleasant it is. And now, finally, I actually feel like I'm playing some golf. Been endless waiting, sometimes 10 to 15 minutes before teeing off, and obviously roasting hot, and just a feeling of being, as I said in my notes in my golf book, being in a supermarket with all the trolleys stacked up, or being in a massive traffic jam. So it's been it's been pretty shit, to be honest. But I only came to play because Unico, when I arrived, said, no, tournament, first time ever that I've been there, there's a tournament, and so I couldn't actually play. But I noticed that when I was there the other day, there were no signs up saying tournament coming. I certainly didn't see any, so I went all the way out there and I couldn't play. But anyway, it's quite good to just discover this place now, especially now that I'm actually beginning to think I might enjoy it. Yeah, more waiting. So it was about 7 or 8 minutes on the tee, then I smack it down the middle pretty nicely. And now we're gonna wait, I don't know, it's be about 5 or 6 minutes for the second shot. It's like crazy. But at least things have improved since I began. I've only had one par, lost a few balls, have done some quite nice shots at times, but it's just been, again, one of those experiences of just thinking, well, there's no point in playing golf. But of course, it is the first time here, and it's very disorientating playing a course anyway, but let alone when you're backed up with, you know, six buggies behind you and you're trying to work out where you've even got to hit the ball, and then you've got to remember to try and hit the ball, and then it's just really the absolute wrong conditions to play in. So I didn't do too badly, especially when I started out driving the other two. One was probably in his mid-70s, the other one must have been about my age. But I was hitting further than him on a few occasions. So I was doing actually quite well. And they were having a few mares anyway, and they've been playing here. Well, one of them said they've been playing here 10 years. So there you go. But it's the expense. It's 2,850, and they've got to pay for a caddy, so it'll be over, you know, it'll be 3,250. And is it worth it? Well, today, no. But this is just reconnaissance anyway, so I shall soon recover. And I think I'm ready to play. I didn't strike it too badly, went nice and high into the water. So I think that's only my third ball lost, could be the fourth. But yeah. This is the first time I've walked any of the course, because I don't feel in the need to race off in the buggy, because I can see someone's on the tee now, but they're sort of two shots back, and so there's suddenly not any hurry, or not the same hurry, and automatically like that it feels like I'm playing golf rather than playing some sort of ridiculous, frenetic, horrible sport where there's sort of, I don't know, racing around in buggies and then just ghastly. Too many people around, it's much noisier than my normal life. And you know, golf's meant to be some sort of quiet psychological escape and test. Incredible greens here actually. And very, very hard. This one's undulating like mad. But you can't see it, but it's just like a huge hump at the back here. Yeah, easy to four putt something like this, Christ.
อยู่ซ้ายออกมา
Well, I hit the trees on that one. Trying to cut it in, and it was just completely useless. My God, I'm about 10 over the bogey par already. And this is going to add nicely to it. Gets worse. I won't even be able to swing on this one.
Hello?
It's as if I've never played the game. I literally sort of not bothering and just completely hacking and being stupid now. But yeah, I just lost the will to live with the game today, especially now when I thought I was going to enjoy the last few holes. Gosh, it's just crazy. So that was the 58 Vokey from 61 yards, choke down. So of course I had no idea that that was the a former bunker. As we go down into it, and I'm on the side, about 60 yards from the green, virtually impossible. Of the day. No, that really was shot of the day. It was so difficult position. And then I just thought, take the 58, it was 50 yards, see what happens. And gone well over the pin, but stopped on the green. So that's pretty tasty. So yeah, more waiting. I can see five carts, there's five people in front, and they're looking for a ball. It's just crazy. At least I got something out of today. I quite enjoyed a few shots, but it's just, you know, your focus is just so scattered by the newness, then by the waiting, and then by bad play. So you're trying to contend with all those things, and the whole experience overall is just, it's just not worth it. It's just not worth it. The extra expense is just so slow. And yeah, I mean, it's tedious. And yeah, and then throw in bad play. And yeah, it's just not enjoyable. Just had a good whinge there about never coming back again, and then do my drive of the day. Such a pity I'm not really enjoying it. All the waiting, all the expense, all the bad play, the frustration. When you think it took me about 20 minutes to get here. And a fantastic course. Even though, you know, I haven't been able to see it properly because I've been not enjoying it. But an amazing course to have 20 minutes away, 30 minutes away at most. Even with the large expense, you know, it'd be lovely if I came and played here, even if it was just once a month for a bit of sort of longer golf. But after today's experience, it's going to be very difficult to do it. I even, when I arrived, I even walked out when, you know, the start, I said, yes, I could play. I went into the clubhouse and they said, oh, you'll have to wait an hour or two. And then I went back to the start and they said, no, you'll be able to play in the next half an hour, not even half an hour. And he was on the phone on his walkie-talkie and I just said, no, doesn't matter, I'm going home. Because I'd already had enough and I walked off. And I'd got about 150 metres. And he picked me up in the came by in a buggy and said, no, you can play right away. And went to the second hole to play right away with two members. And I thought, well, fair enough, me being stroppy got me on the course. But I don't think I'd want to be a member here, spending all that money on membership and they have to put up with someone just turning up because you have to play with a member, you can't play on your own unless you're in a group. I mean, you know, if you were a member, would you really want someone tagging along? I mean, they didn't seem to mind, but Christ, just shows how bad it really is. Yeah, I mean, it's bad enough for me, but for them, even if they didn't mind, I just thought, surely they would. Yeah, it's just a bad sign if people who've paid the membership can have to play with someone who just turns up. Just seems crazy to me. But yeah, what a pity that I can't just play this course every so often. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll give it another chance. But it's certainly whetting the appetite to go down to Hua Hin the week after next when it's half term. Because at least there I know I can get on the course and it's not that bad. And I like it anyway. But it just shows how much I like Unico. It's short and sweet and difficult in its way, and I can score well. So what more do you want? only the second par of the day. The other one was a par three, that's a par five. Box on the left, 146 apparently to the pin. Still got 3 or 4 holes to play. Still got the first hole to play as well. I think we're on the 16th. Yeah, I think it's the 16th. Guess what I'm doing at the moment. Yeah, waiting for people on the green. So yeah, I mean, rhythm of play is important for everyone, from professionals down to people like me, all the way down the food chain. And it's exceptionally hard to get any rhythm when you're just, when you're playing a shot every so often. But yeah, I might give it the benefit of the doubt and have another go at some stage on a less busy day. They reckon if you come here at 6, it's less busy. Yeah, great. You know, the fact that it's so near to home is a big thing in its favour, so I might give it another chance. But it's just that expense of, I mean, today, it looks like you have to have a cart. I haven't seen anyone walking. So 2,850, 3,200, I mean, basically, it's triple what it cost me at Unico. And there, I mean, obviously triple is crazy. I could just go around there for a longer course. I could just go around the front 9 6 times for the same price and get plenty of practice. But this is good. There are aspects of it that are good. I mean, it's a proper full-length course. It's not extremely long. It's probably only like Chelsfield, but it feels long because I'm just not used to it. But it's very much like Royal Hoar Hin in terms of length. Might be a bit longer. But yeah, you got to have quieter conditions and less people, fewer people, and then it might be all right. But also, I suppose you've got to give it a chance, because first time of playing here, obviously, it's all pretty confusing, especially as I walked out at the beginning and then was chased down, and suddenly I could play, and it felt very strange and alien. And not an enjoyable experience, but now it's turned more into a game of golf. The new shot of the day. I even got a clap.
Ee 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 ee
never bothered to move the camera up a 7-foot curler. Lots of good shots now from the caddy. She's cheered up, like I have as well. But you know, it's quite simple why I've cheered up, because I'm playing better, but I'm playing better because I'm not being flustered by constant carts and noise and feeling of having to hurry. That certainly helps. About a 5 or 6 minute wait. Five people on the green, five caddies. Literally forgotten how to play. And then he misses and picks the ball up. That was the new Vokey. Wasn't in the bunker. Just a gentle little chip. Beautiful shot. Like a Unico shot, 85 yards, sand wedge, high up in the air, dropped quite near to the pin. So there haven't been that many shots like that today, but I suppose overall there's been a few good shots, and that was one of the best ones after that terrible or very poor about 90 yard hybrid shot which I topped. But I made up for it with a beautiful shot there. So as I always say, it's not quite the end of the world, just relatively close. Relatively close to the pin as well. So actually could still get a par. Hole this and I get a par. If I don't, bogey par, not too bad after a pretty lousy round with a few highlights.